Hi, let's talk about the pharyngeal muscles. In this video, we'll discuss the muscles of the wall of the pharynx, identifying each muscle's attachments and their actions. So the pharyngeal muscles fall into one of two groups. Each group has three muscles. So there are the constrictor muscles and the longitudinal muscles. In the illustration to the right here, we can see the three pairs of constrictor muscles quite well. So this is the inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle, and nestled within it is the middle pharyngeal constrictor muscle, and nestled within that is the superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle. These muscles attach to the skull, the hyoid, and the larynx, respectively, and they meet their counterpart along a midline seam called the pharyngeal or FA. That's where the investing fascia of these muscles coalesces to hold them together. Now, the longitudinal muscles aren't fully visible from this posterior view. The only one which we can see well is the stylopharyngeus muscle. That stylopharyngeus muscle, it originates on the styloid process of the temporal bone, and it's going to insinuate itself between superior and middle pharyngeal constrictor muscles. Also note the relationship of the stylopharyngeus muscle with cranial nerve number 9, the glossopharyngeal nerve. That is a classic anatomical relationship that you're going to want to keep in mind. Now, these longitudinal muscles are elevators of the larynx during deglutition, and as they elevate the larynx, they're also going to shorten and widen the pharynx, which will probably best be seen when we open the pharyngeal wall. Now, all of these muscles are innervated by the pharyngeal neural plexus, except stylopharyngeus. The stylopharyngeus muscle is one of the glaring exceptions to the rule of the pharyngeal plexus, and it is completely innervated by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Now, the pharyngeal constrictor muscles, of which there are three, consist of the superior, middle, and inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle. That superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle takes its origin on the skull. So part of it is on the sphenoid bone down to the mylohyoid line, and then there's a condensation of connective tissue between the two called the pterygomandibular raphae. So that is a condensation of the investing fascia of that superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle, as well as the buccinator muscle that is anterior to it. Buccinator means is the muscle of the cheek. So one can see how the oral cavity and the pharynx are going to be contiguous with one another from an outer muscular architecture sense. Now, the middle pharyngeal constrictor muscle is going to attach itself to the hyoid bone, and the superior pharyngeal constrictor muscle nestles within it. So both of these come together along that midline raphae, and the middle nestles within the inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle, which originates from the larynx. Now, it attaches to both the thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage, which are of the larynx. So there are two parts to this inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle. Now, all of these muscles work to serially constrict the pharynx from the top to the bottom, and all of them are innervated by the pharyngeal plexus. Now, if we take a posterior view of the pharynx with the wall split, so the pharyngeal raphae has been incised and this has been reflected away, we can see the pathways of these longitudinal muscles. It's probably best to keep in mind that the longitudinal muscles all are named in ways that will help you recall their proximal attachment sites. So, for instance, recall that stylopharyngeus muscle attaches to the styloid process of the temporal bone. That muscle comes down, parts the superior from the middle pharyngeal constrictor muscle, as we can see here, to insert on the thyroid cartilage of the larynx. There's also a salpingopharyngeus muscle. Salpinx means horn, and they're referencing the torus tuberius there. The salpingopharyngeus muscle originates on the outer part of the auditory tube, and it descends down and it blends with another muscle called the palatopharyngeus. And the two of these come down to insert on the wall of the pharynx as well, ultimately, as the thyroid cartilage. So that palatopharyngeus muscle is originating on the soft palate, specifically the palatine aponeurosis there. So it comes down and blends with salpingopharyngeus, and the two of these as one larger muscle come down to insert on the thyroid cartilage and the wall of the larynx. So as these longitudinal muscles contract, they're going to elevate the larynx during the deglutition or swallowing reflex. And as they elevate the larynx, they also tug up on the wall of the pharynx, which is going to widen the walls and shorten the total depth of the pharynx. So it elevates the larynx, shortens and widens the pharynx. One other thing to note is that this palatopharyngeus muscle is what is the posterior border of the fauces. So as it's invested by mucosa, that is the palatopharyngeal fold, which the two comprise the palatopharyngeal arch. So that's still within the oropharynx, but it's just the posterior border of the fauces. So we've discussed the two sets of pharyngeal muscles, the constrictors and the longitudinal muscles, discussed how they're named, their attachments, and their actions. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.